Hi everyone, welcome back to part two of this book project. I hope you enjoyed part one, making your own book cloth. In this video, I'm going to bind my book using a slip knot method. First, I'd like to show you a few examples to give you some ideas for designing your own book using this method. In this one, I put these two buttons on and they have very large holes that are spaced wide apart. I use those holes to decide the placement of my stitching lines. So for this one, I had two buttons I wanted to put on, but four very big holes spread far apart meant a four lines of stitching. On this book, I had three buttons, but the holes in the buttons are much smaller, so I only needed one line of stitching for each button. But it's the same binding method. This one, I didn't have anything on the covers. My knots are actually in the back on the inside of the book. And since each line of stitching has its own needle and thread, this one was fun to alternate the colors of the thread. Everyone could be different. You can alternate them. You can do them all the same. It doesn't matter. It's up to you. And this one is bound with some very heavy cardstock. I reinforced it a little bit so that I wouldn't rip the pages. Reinforced it with some washi tape, which is another option you can do. This one is made with envelopes and reinforced with a little bit of scrapbook paper and some decorative eyelets as well. And then beads attached to the back. And that was attached to the back before I knotted my book closed. So you'll see in the sample video that I give for the slip knot binding, these different ways of finishing off your book. So let's get started on this one. Okay, it's time to bind our book. We have our covers that are dried from being under weights overnight. They look really good, nice and flat. And I have my interior pages. For this slip knot binding, you use single sheets, not signatures, for your interior pages. So I have 12 pieces of 140 pound watercolor paper. So nice and heavy so that it is sturdy to stand up for a single page. I have needles, I have an awl to poke my holes, I have some graph paper that I will be making my template for stitching holes, some waxed linen thread, a ruler, a pencil, and I plan on putting these decorative buttons on the front of my cover, so I have those available too, and they will determine where my sewing holes are going to be placed. So I'm going to link a demo that I did for a sample of the slip knot binding. I would strongly advise you to do the sample, which just gives a demo of the sewing method that we're going to use. It's based on a macrame knot, just a very simple slip knot, and it connects each of your pages. But rather than to jump right into a book project, it would be worth your while to just get some scraps, like cereal box, cut it into pieces, and try the sample stitching. So I will link that video in here. I highly recommend you watch that through and then come back to this one. Okay, so I have my grid paper here to mark where I want to punch my holes. So the grid paper is the same height as my book. I have these buttons that I want to place on the cover, and they're going to determine where I do my stitching holes because I want my stitching holes to come out from these holes here. And so my buttons are going to be, the first hole for the button is going to be 1 inch down and a half an inch in. So I'm going to do, these are four squares per inch. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and a half an inch in means this is going to be here. And then this one too, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then half an inch in. And then these holes are about 3/8 inches apart. So I'm going to mark that. So that is where I'm going to have my holes for my book. Now, this is my front cover. And this is the head of my book. This is the top of my book. So what I'm going to do here is mark these. And I'm just doing a little bit of a prick in there so that I can see where my holes are going to be. And then I'll remove the template and I'll poke these a little bit firmer, and I'll use maybe a catalog or something so that I don't go through my mat. And I just want it to go through the board so that I can see them on the other side. And then I'm going to turn it over and poke the holes deeper on the fabric side so that it doesn't really push out my fabric. So I can't quite see them yet, so I'm going to put them through a little bit more. I can just barely see them. Now I need to poke them, and they need to be a pretty good size hole, because once we start sewing this, I'm going to be using double thread. And the covers are going to have the thread go through at least twice. So you need to be able to run that thread through. Pretty good size holes. So I don't know if you can see that. See if I have it under the white. It's easier if you hold it up to the light and make sure that you get your holes on there right. Okay, so this is the top of my book. I actually need to mark the tops of my my covers and everything, and my pages, so that I make sure that I have them all facing the right direction. Sometimes flipping the template around can make things off, so you want to make sure that you're always keeping the template and your pages all in the same direction. Okay. And to mark my back cover, I'm going to line up my front cover to the back cover to mark these. It usually is just a little more accurate than doing the template. Okay, so there's my back cover and my front cover. And if I put the buttons up there, yeah, they line up really well. I'm trimming down my template to the size of my signatures. And once I've punched my covers, because remember, my pages are slightly narrower than my covers. So to line this up, I'll make sure that is aligned and punch my holes. Okay, so to demonstrate what this is going to look like, I'm going to show you one that I've used a similar method with buttons on the front to show you how the thread gets used. Each sewing hole gets its own needle and thread. And if you'll notice, on each page or cover, you have a double width of thread from this hole to the edge of the book. On the front cover, On the inside cover, we'll have extra in order to bring that button forward. So there's actually 4 lengths of thread on this side and 2 on the cover. Okay, so that's a thread that you're using up. And then on each page, it's 2 on each side of the page. That's 2. See how that's 2 threads. So we need to calculate how much thread to use for each sewing hole. And there's roughly a formula. If this is 1/2 inch in from the edge of the board, times 6 lengths of thread, 6 times 1/2 inch is 3 inches. So for every sewing hole, you need 3 inches, roughly 3 inches, for each page, including the covers of your book. My book has 12 pages plus the 2 covers, and their sewing holes are 1/2 inch in. So 1/2 inch times 6 for each page is 3, times 14, which is the number of pages plus my covers, equals 42, plus a few extra inches just to make sure you get enough. I'm cutting about 50 inches of thread for each sewing hole. And each sewing hole gets its own thread and its own needle. So I have strung each 50-inch strip onto my needles to double up the thread, okay? The way that you put these on, make sure you have an eye that's big enough for 2 widths of your thread. You do the loose ends through the eye, and you'll have a loop at the bottom, and that's how we're going to attach our cover. Since I want my threads to end up on the front so that I can tie my buttons on, I'm going to start with the back cover. So I'm going to flip everything else over here because I'm going to be working from back to front. So come up through the outside and bring my needle through the loop. Okay, and I'm going to do that for each sewing hole. And that's going to attach all of my threads, or all of my needles, in a slip knot. And then from there, we'll add our pages on. Okay, so I'm going to be putting my pages on now. I have all 4 of these tight on my cover. I'll take the first needle, I'll put it down through the page, and just like in that demo video, open out the loop and bring your thread through. The demo video is a little different because I wasn't using needles, but the concept is exactly the same. So I'll bring my next needle for the next hole. Pull it through, and you'll have to just thread it through between the pages and the cover. Open out the hole. And through the loop. Like I said, it looks a little bit different because of using a needle, but the concept is the same and the knot is the same. And because this is watercolor paper, you want to pull things so that they're taut, not like leaving a gap, but so that they're not tight. Like you don't want to rip your paper, so don't pull it too tight. So I'm pulling that through. Go between the pages and the cover. Open out my loops here. And bring the needle through. Last one on this page. And I'm going to make sure that they're taut, but not super tight because I don't want to rip my paper. And this is what it looks like after the in between the very last page of my book and the back cover. That's what each page is going to look like. I am going to bind the rest of this off camera until I get to my front cover, and then I'll come back on and I'll show you the finish. Okay, I thought I would come back on. I have my last page and the front cover to go on, but I thought I would finish the rest of it on camera. You can see how my stitches are forming this nice braid. Each thread is doing that for each of my pages. There's a nice separation between the pages, and that's one reason I like this binding is because it allows for you to put things on the paper. I plan on doing some collage in this page or in this book, so there's room between each page without making the book bow open. So I'm going to put the last page on. I'm flipping this over. This is actually my first page in the book since I'm working back to front. So the same way that I did all the other pages, I'm going to add this one. Bringing this back through the loop, pulling it tight, next page or the next hole. My hands are getting sticky from the wax, linen, thread, so things are sticking all over the place at this point. Okay, and now I'm going to put on the front cover. Make sure everything is aligned here and relatively even, relatively taut. And we're going to put on the front cover, going down, opening out the loop. My thread got twisted here, sorry. Bringing the needle back through the loop and pulling that tight. Next one. Okay, I'm pulling this tight, but not so tight that I'm going to rip anything. Now, I'm going to, I want my threads to end up on the top, so I need to unthread the needles. Bring these around, thread this between the cover and the first page. I'm gonna have to pull that tight again because it came loose. And I'll bring that in there. I'll do that with all of these because they are going to loosen up individually. So I'm basically splitting the thread open for each sewing hole and then threading each end on either side of the stitch between the front cover and the front page or first page. Okay, now that I have them all on the insides, I'm going to pull them tight. Make sure you have the right pairs. Pull each one tight, each pair of threads. Pull them tight. And I'm going to tie a knot in each pair. And that's a square knot. Left over right, right over left. And then leave that loose. Each pair. Left over right, right over left. And then let that one go. And this pair. Okay, and now these will get threaded through back to the front cover. If you can do this through your holes without putting them back on the needle, great. I think my holes are going to be too tight for that. So I'll have to thread mine back onto the needle and pull this up. So do that for each hole. I won't make you sit through watching me thread all of these needles, but you're pulling that through each hole. So your threads come back out the front cover. Okay. Now I have all of my threads on the outside of my book. I'm going to put them through my buttons. Each pair of threads is going to go through one of these very large holes. And then I'm going to tie them in a knot. And this is only securing the button to the book because the book's already been secured together. So I just did a square knot. I'll attach this one. And then I'm going to snip these off. Okay, so here's our finished book. You can see the braiding on the spine for each of the sewing threads. And there's plenty of room in between the pages to do collage or painting, whatever you would like. I would go through and erase all of my inner markings and then call it done. Thanks for coming along. I'll see you next time.